I have not listened to this song yet. I will be reacting and reviewing to this song. A couple days ago, I reviewed the new Florence and the Machine lead single called Hunger on their new album, High as Hope. I have not listened to the second lead single yet called Big God, and I've been saving this for this review and reaction video. I'm very excited to listen to this song. Let's get started. Let's have a listen.
Need a big God, big enough to hold your love. Need a big God.
Wow, right off the bat, the vocals are so upfront in the mix that you need to be focused on them. There is some bassy piano and a little bit of scratchy violin that is happening in the background that's making the song a bit eerie right away. I need a big God. Those lyrics are a little bit like, is she talking about a God religiously? Is that a metaphor for something else? Interesting beginning, just because you have to be so focused on her vocals because they are so upfront.
Well, you can never know the places that I go, I still like you the most.
So it looks like we have a pre-chorus melody happening here. She's built some harmony layers, so things are getting a little busier. Likely going to move into a chorus drop here. Kind of excited. Is some type of bucket snare happening here that's not, I'm not a huge fan of. It sounds like it could be so much better with a nice cracky snare, but it's almost like someone just hitting a dull bucket. Obviously, that's the sound they wanted to go for. Maybe it's sounds very almost folky sound, because you could recreate that sound literally with a bucket and a drumstick.
Hard at the process. Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, it hurts. Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, it hurts. Need a big God.
Interesting bridge almost in the song. Completely different melody to the chorus melody and the verse melody. And the lyrics that really stand out there are, Jesus Christ, it hurts. Is this just part of the process? So obviously there's some pain going on here, which is reflected in the instrumentation, because I almost feel at that part I was walking through a haunted house. There were like creaky sounds and eerie string sounds. I'll play that here. It's like that clappy thing that almost makes me think that bats are like flying around. But then we come back to that steady 4/4 tempo. There is now a nice drum kit there. It's distinct from that buckety snare drum kit here. So now we have a solid drum kit sound, and the song really, the 2 minutes and 14 seconds in, the song is now starting to really drive.
Big enough to hold your love.
So a lot of layers happening now. There are some trumpets. I'm really building up the song, but still, I Need a Big God is sticking lyrically, so she's driving this home as an anthem type song. Big drop here with that nice crunchy drum kit coming in here. I am a fan of this, just because it roots the song with a better drum kit. We've only seen bits of so far in the song, but now we finally have an alternative rock drum kit, which is their genre, and we need that to make it feel like a Florence and the Machine song. So I'm glad this is here. Listen to it here come in. It's very crunchy, and it just makes the song come together. Now we're dying out here, 30 seconds left.
Slide down to the sea.
a couple things that I like right there. Not only the drum kit, but Florence Welch really hit that high range vocals here. That is a high note to hit, and she hits it perfectly. Now we're down at the end of the song. We have the matching piano at the beginning of the song that is just going to keep that melody throughout the song. But we have these nice claps. Still sustain that crunchy drum kit, but just blend well with a piano that's going to tail out here. That's the song. The last 15-20 seconds were also that very haunted, dark, eerie feeling. She's doing that thing with her voice here, where it's kind of sounding like a bullfrog almost. Dark trumpet that is coming in there. Very kind of haunted, dark feeling at the end here, which she is going for. It makes you think, it makes you just feel that it's haunted. So I'm going to give this song an 8.5 out of 10. I almost like it more than the lead single, Hunger. And I think I like it just because it's more unique and it has that haunted, dark feeling to it that makes it mysterious. So that is my review of Big God by Florence and the Machine. Let me know what you think if you disagree. If you're new here, please subscribe. Let me know what you think in the comments. I do a song review and reaction definitely every Sunday. I'll see you in the next video. And hold on, my tender, yes,